because of the names you heard outside, and most especially, you hear them from those you call your Christian brothers and sisters. Jesus said, go hither and call for your husband. And the woman said, I have no husband. Jesus said unto her, thou hast said, I have no husband, for thou hast 5 husbands, and he whom thou hast is not thy husband. In the midst, in that said that truly. That interaction means the woman was sincere. Sincerity between the conversation of both of them. The woman was sincere to Jesus and said, sir, I have no husband. And Jesus said, truly, you have no husband. You have 5 already, and the one that you are with is not your husband. Sincerity is what the kingdom of God wants. If you are sincere enough, if you can be sincere enough to serve God from the deep of your heart, if you can be sincere enough from the deep of your heart, then we be cleansing. Let somebody shout amen. Amen. If there is sincerity, there will be cleansing. This woman, when she was sincere to Jesus, to tell Jesus the truth, sir, I have no husband. Let's continue. The woman said to him, sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our father worship in this mountain. And he said that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Jesus said unto her, woman, believe me, the hours cometh where he shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. If worship he not, know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. Then the woman was replying to Jesus, but the hour cometh, and that is when the true worshiper shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeks such to worship him. God is in spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in truth and in spirit. The woman said unto him, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. Jesus said unto her, the I that speak unto thee, I'm here. Tell somebody, Jesus is here. I am here, the Messiah, the one who has come to cleanse the land, the one who has come to redeem you from your sin, the one who has come to change you from that situation, the one who has come to make you pure again. I am here. Child of God, I don't know what your problem, your situation is, but I have a good news for you. I have a good news for you. I have a good news for you. Only believe in him, only accept him, only cling to him. That is the way. That is the way. The Bible says Jesus is the only way. Jesus is the truth. And Jesus is the life that both of us seek for.
Amen. I don't mind.
Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. They say that perceive that you are the Messiah. How many of you know that Jesus is the Messiah in you? How many of you are Jesus? Have an encounter with another person. The woman with the issue. issue of glory. What is the issue that is standing before you? What is the issue that is making you to feel that there is no more? What is that issue? The woman of the issue of glory, she has been rejected, abandoned, forsaken by lovers, by father and mothers, by brothers and sisters. Anywhere she go, they call her name. She's famous. That was the woman, the blood of issue, the issue of blood. Anywhere she go, wherever she goes, at the least people will run away. I tell you, I don't know what you are going through, but I'm here to make a declaration. Because of your situation, people will give way for you, and that way that we give to you will thank you. Let's take a look at this woman. And behold, a woman which was diseased with an issue of blood 20 years came behind and touched the hem of his garment. They used the word "it came behind." Do you know why it came behind? Because as she was coming with her problem, people were giving way for her. Your problem will make a way for you. Your problem will make a way for you. She's coming. Everybody was giving way for her. And the Bible says, and she touched. Only your touch will give you healing. Amen. Only your touch will give you healing. Amen. Only your touch will give you deliverance. Amen. Only your touch will set you free. Amen. Then she began to move. She began to move. The Bible says she pushed. She began to push, and the people were giving way for her. She pushed, and she pushed, and she pushed. In the way of your struggling, the time you struggle, and you think that all hope is gone, that time that is getting worse, that is time your freedom is coming. That time that is getting worse, that is time your freedom is coming. That time that is getting worse, that is time your freedom is coming. You are important. Tell somebody I'm important. Tell somebody I am important. Say somebody I am important. If you like talking about me, I am important. The more they speak of you, it's like they are publishing you. You don't understand. You don't understand because the Bible says it uses the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. They think they are wise. They think they have knowledge. They think they know exactly what they are doing. Destroy you. They are making you to look good. The more they destroy you, they are making way for you. The more they destroy you. And the disciples said, "Master, how can you say that power has who touched you? Who touched you? How can you say somebody touched you when there are multitude, a lot of people here, a lot of people around you? How can you say who touched you?" Then he said, "If I may touch his garment, I shall be made whole." I don't know why you are here. I don't know why you are here. I don't know why you came to this convention. I believe I'm talking to somebody. You have asked, "When will I be free?" You've asked, you've cried in the night. You've sucked your pillow with tears. You've cried day and night. Lord, when my children come, Lord, when will you bless me? The hour has come. 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 If only she will touch him. If only she will touch him. If only you would touch him. If only you would touch him.
He's here to make you whole. 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 You are not here in accident. You are not here because you want to come. You are here for a reason. You did not just come to go showcase yourself. But there is a reason why you are here. I believe I'm talking to somebody. The hours have come for you to touch Jesus. The hours have come for you to touch Jesus. If you are here for Jesus to touch you, I want you to be on your feet.
Touch me now.
If you know that you need a touch of Jesus, look around. Don't see what people will call you. Just take a bold step, just the way the woman did. And she took the bold step.